Plastics or paper? A simple choice that has important environmental consequences. Why plastic should be banned? Will paper be a better alternative? Let's see. Let's get to know a little about plastics. It is very essential to know what is plastic. Is it organic chemical, inorganic chemical, and how it comes into existence and how we started using them. Plastics are used on a daily basis throughout the world. The word plastic is a common term that is used for many materials of a synthetic or semi-synthetic nature. The term was derived from the Greek plastikos, which means fit for molding. In the early part of the 20th century, a big boom occurred in polymer chemistry when polymer materials such as nylon and Kevlar came on the scene. Much of the work done with polymers focuses improvement by using existing technologies. There is a need for the development of a new application for polymers and always looking for less expensive materials that can replace what is used now. Plastics are a wide variety of combinations of properties when viewed as a whole. They are used for shellac, cellulose, rubber, and asphalt. This list could go on, and it's obvious that much of what we have today would not be possible without plastics. The physical structure of a polymer chain is important. It determines the microscopic properties. Conformation and configuration are terms used to describe the geometric structure of a polymer. Configuration speaks to the order that is determined by chemical bonds, and conformation speaks to the order that comes from the rotation of the molecules about the single bond. Due to its low costs, plastic have become a staple product in the world nowadays, which consequently affects the environment since it releases toxins and harmful substances into the air. Besides that, there is also a steady rise due to the cost of the fuels needed for its production. The solution for this problem is still unknown, but science is working on the problem. Only time will tell what the future of plastics will be, but it is unlikely that the world will ever be without them. Plastic bags are made as a single-use product. Their cheap manufacturing costs allow them to become the default choice at supermarket checkout counters. But the problem is, cheap price doesn't account for the environmental cost of using plastic bags. So, what sort of problem are they? Plastic pollution is where plastic has gathered in an area and has begun to negatively impact natural environment and create problems for the plants, wildlife, and even the human population. Plastic is an incredibly useful material, but still, it is also made from toxic compound known to cause illness, and because it is meant for durability, it is not biodegradable. Humans are responsible for producing 300 million tons of plastic each year, half of which is used only once then discarded away. Of the million of tons of plastic produced each year, only a fraction of it ever finds its way to a recycling plant. Even conservative studies estimate over 8 million tons of plastic are dumped into the world's ocean annually. Plastic is reputed as being nearly indestructible. It can take hundreds or even thousands of years to fully decompose. Derived fossil fuels, plastic, and its exponential growth is a threat in many ways, from poisoning and injuring marine life to disrupting human hormones and causing early puberty. According to the EDN, About 9.1 billion tons of virgin, which is non-recycled plastic, has been produced to date. We have generated 6.9 billion tons of plastic waste, and only 9% has been recycled, and plastic production is predicted to be tripled in the next 25 years. Plastic bags comes to only a fraction of overall waste. Still, for a tip, they have some qualities that makes them really dangerous when it exposed to the environment. So what do you think? Should plastic bag be banned? I would say yes. Plastic bags are everywhere. Look around and you will notice that plastic bags are the most common litter, tangled in trees and fences, floating in water, lying on the grounds in parks, and also washed off on beaches. Because they are so lightweight, plastic bag gets easily picked up by wind and travel long distance by wind and water to pollute the nature. As plastic is less expensive, it is one of the most widely available and overused item in the world today. As plastic bags tend to get caught in recycling machinery, most recycling facilities do not have the capacity to recycle plastic bags, and therefore they do not accept them. In fact, plastic bags are considered by many recycling facilities the number one contaminant, and their removal from the recycling stream causes municipalities close to 1 million a year. The majority of plastic bags are made of polyethylene, a substance that is derived from the crude oil refining and the natural gas processing. Oil and natural gas are non-renewable fossil fuel based on resource, and through their extraction and production, they emit greenhouse gases which contributes to global climate change. Using this non-renewable resource to make plastic bags is very short-sighted, considering that the typical useful life of each plastic bag is about 12 minutes and that the world's oil reserves contain enough oil to cover our needs through 2050. Petroleum-based plastic bags are composed of very resistant synthetic polymers that may take up to 1,000 years or never until they completely degrade in natural environments. What does occur in most instances is that when out in the environment, the plastic breaks up into tiny microscopic pieces that get deposited in the soil where we grow food or contaminate waterways. These pieces can be so small that they are invisible to our eyes. Researchers found that the mass of microscopic plastic fragment in the North Pacific Central Gyre was 6 times higher than the plankton. The subtropical gyre of the North Pacific Ocean are also documented to contain the highest concentration of plastic. Plastic bags floating in the ocean resemble jellyfish, one of the main source of food for some species of sea turtles, especially the critically endangered leatherback turtle. According to a study carried out in 2013, up to 35% of turtle deaths were caused by plastic ingestion, and the probability that sea turtles will consume even more plastic increases every year. Plastic bags are often mistaken for food by animals, birds, and marine lives. The consumed plastic congests the digestive tracts of this animal and can lead to health issues such as infections, painful intestinal blockage, starvation, or death suffocation. Many of you may have heard it already. Tiny plastic particles have been found in human feces, but is it really surprising? Microplastic were found in soft drinks like Coca-Cola, in tap water, in seafood. It has contaminated our food chain, so it should not be surprised that it can be tracked in our body. In fact, according to researchers, every second person on the planet could have some microplastic in the body. The reason to worry is that scientists do not know how our metabolism and immunity will react to the increased concentration of plastic particles in our system. They suspected that it may add stress on the liver by introducing more pathogen into the body. Additionally, plastic in our digestive tract may affect absorption of some important trace element like iron, which we need for maintaining proper health. If there is one piece of advice that everyone should remember, it would be that nothing is for free in this world. While we may not pay for plastic bags directly when we go shopping, they are anything but free. On average, plastic bags cost retailers about 20 to 30 cents each. It may not seem like much, but when you imagine how many bags they have to provide throughout the year, you will quickly realize that plastic bags are costly. So retailers incorporate this cost hiddenly into prices of other items sold at stores. Additionally, someone has to pay the cost of dealing with plastic bags in the waste stream. These include waste collection, regular cleanups to remove plastic bags littered along the roads or blown away from landfill, and then even processing at landfill sites. This includes the true environmental causes of resource extraction and depletion, the loss of quality lives, economic loss from littering, and wildlife loss. Unfortunately, such causes are typically not included in most economic analyses, as they are not easy to calculate because the equation would have to involve many indirect variables. However, in 2014, the United Nations Environment Programme supported the first project to calculate the real cost of plastic, including adverse environmental impact of its production, use and disposal. The result numbering is staggering. Plastic use costs approximately to $75 billion a year. When was the last time you were at a grocery store and heard someone ask you paper or plastic? It seems like in a lot of places that phrase is long gone. Plastic bags are pretty much ubiquitous, although they are being taxed and banned in a number of cities. So why do you think this paper bag is a better option in replacing plastic bags? Paper bags have a much higher global warming potential. The manufacture of paper bags is much more resource intensive than plastic, consuming larger amounts of energy and water. Plastic bags were invented as an alternative to paper groceries bags in the late 1970s to protect trees and prevent clear cutting of our forests. The strain of ethane gas is conserved, captured and frozen before it can be burnt off into the atmosphere. According to the Scottish Government's 2005 report on plastic shopping bags, the manufacture of paper bags consumes 4 times more water than the manufacture of plastic bags, and paper generates 3 times more greenhouse gases. The EcoBilan Care for Life cycle assessment shows that in their manufacture, paper bags consume 2.2 times more non-renewable energy than the manufacture of plastic bags. Paper bags tend to fail on reuse because they tear easily and are not waterproof. Conventional plastic bags are highly reusable and outperform paper. They are reused as carry bags and as kitchen catchers for garbage and organics among their many uses. The 2011 UK Environment Agency study of supermarket carry bags found that paper bags contribute 3 times more to global warming than conventional plastic shopping bags. The most significant and immediate impact of a switch from plastic shopping bags to paper grocery bags is the additional volume and tonnage that paper adds to the waste stream. This additional volume correlates directly to the significant increase in the amount of greenhouse gases emissions produced to transport it. Paper grocery bags are heavier than plastic bags. The typical plastic shopping bag weighs around 6 to 8 grams. A standard craft paper bag weighs 55 grams. This leads to additional waste management and recycling costs. Paper bags tend to have higher recycling rates than plastic bags. Recycling rates of plastic bags in Canada are high. The Ontario Minister of the Environment's 2010 report on the 50% plastic bags reduction program determined a 36% recycling rate in municipalities recovering bags in the blue box. In BC and Alberta, over 30% of the bags are recycled. In Quebec, 33% of all plastic shopping bags are recycled. And in Atlantic Canada, with pioneered back-to-back recycling system working with large grocery retailers, rates are higher. 50% in NS and 57% in PEI. So, what is the conclusion? Many believe that paper bags are more environmentally friendly than plastic bags because they are made from a renewable resource, can biodegrade, and are recyclable. This belief is not based on science or fact, but it is based on misconceptions about how plastic bags are made, how landfills work, and the incidence of plastic litter. Plastic bags should be banned due to its many drawbacks, such as its harmfulness to wildlife, marine life, and also human health. Due to its overuseness, it could cause plain old trashes. Besides that, since it is made from non-renewable resources, this could lead to our climate changes. Paper bags cannot be said as better alternative ways, since it requires 2.2 times more non-renewable energy than manufacture of plastic bags. Other than that, paper bags manufacture consume 4.7 times more water, emits 3.1 times more greenhouse gases, and 2.7 times more acid gases than the manufacture of plastic bags. Thus, it can be said that conventional plastic bags are better for the environment than paper bags. So there are heaps of alternatives, and some better than others. Yes, you will need to use them a fair bit to make them worthwhile, but remember that in the long term, the best case scenario is one where we don't use a non-degradable plastic bags at all. So the best thing you can do is to find a reusable bag that suits you, which that will be durable, washable, and also biodegradable. And do just that, reuse it.